This is also going to impact the manufacturing activity a lot in the country because they are not going to return back to the factories since they'll be provided employment in the areas where they've gone back in the native places. So what will be the impact on manufacturing and how many workers are you planning to give employment?
The first priority when we say Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Abhiyan is to deal with the immediate requirement of those workers who have gone back to their respective districts. And therefore to provide them a livelihood as soon as, you know, they are there now already. Some of them would have been there now for 15, 20 days. So this whole idea of getting so many different schemes which have a rural component to be focused on the workers who have reached there so that they immediately utilized and immediately provided with a livelihood. So that's been the primary objective with which we are doing this. Why only 125 days and not more? 120 days translates to 4 months. At least for the next 4 months, we are giving them a clear, concrete a blueprint with which they will be engaged. As we go along, we'll have to see how even many of them would want to be there or want to go back. As they go on, we'll have to take it further. So there is just no reason to think that they will continue, all of them will continue to stay, or just no equally a reason to think that all of them will go away. So the government has come with this solid, all sort of comprehensive blueprint so that they at least immediately provided a livelihood. As we go along, and since I'm also very clearly laying it out that activities which are otherwise spread over 6 months to 1 year, we'll front load now itself so that there is no dearth of money has to be released, you know, utilization has to be provided, and then the flow of money also makes it slower. None of that will hamper these 120 days. And as we go along, we'll have to see how many of them are going to stay back and how many would want to go in search of jobs elsewhere. So we'll have to take it as we go along. It's too early for me to comment on the impact on manufacturing, given the fact that first today, many of them who have gone back are in their places rather than in the place where they were earlier employed. Industries are also doing a lot of reset for themselves. As you know, you're probably aware, I've been engaging with all different industry associations to understand how they are planning and starting to work. Many of them have reported to me that they are already running at 45 to 50% capacity. This is about last week that I'm talking. They're gradually increasing. So we'll have to see how industry is going to plan for either drawing them back or thinking of something else. We'll have to go along. As we go along, we'll be able to get a picture.
Number 26.
Ma'am, why the states like West Bengal is not there? Is it something, is there something like the states were not interested in this?
Well, I don't think it is related to a state which did or did not. Majority of those who went about, has the secretary got anything more to say on this?
So the, West Bengal at the time when the program was being drawn up, as you are also aware that till 15 June it was already taking in the migrant workers. They hadn't already concluded. So at the time when we drew up the contours of the program, the number of migrant workers had not been settled in those Bengal districts, and also then they had, so the fact that we have a cutoff of 25,000 persons per district to take a district in. There is no bar to other districts joining in this initiative. So if we get the numbers, we'll certainly include them. So there is no.
At least 25,000 in a district, we readily took those districts up. And as and when if there is a state which has got some data coming later, we open.
One.
Yes. In the 116 districts that we've given you, in each district, at least 25,000 workers have gone back. And that is the unit which we have taken. The district with 25,000 workers having reached those districts are the ones which make up for the 116.
Number 33.
मैं शैलेश हूँ एनआई से. जैसे आपने बोला कि 25,000 श्रमिकों को जो है रोजगार दिया जाएगा, और स्टेट्स में जैसे संख्या जो आ रही है कि किसी स्टेट में 3 लाख श्रमिक वापस गए, किसी में 4 लाख, उस डेली आंकड़े आते रहते हैं, तो क्या ये 25 लाख का जो कैप आपने अभी बताया इस फिगर?
नहीं, आप क्षमा कीजिए, इसका स्पष्टीकरण करना चाह रही हूँ मैं. 25,000 इन अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट, इसीलिए मैप में आपको दिखाया गया कि उत्तर प्रदेश में बहुत सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स थे, उनका नंबर भी आपको. बिहार में 32 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स है, हर एक में कम 25,000 हम बोल रहे हैं कि माइग्रेंट वर्कर्स गए हैं, हर एक में 25,000 का सेटलमेंट होने का इंफॉर्मेशन है, इसीलिए उस डिस्ट्रिक्ट में 25,000. ऐसे करके 32 डिस्ट्रिक्ट बिहार में, उत्तर प्रदेश में 31 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स है, हर एक में मिनिमम 25,000 है, उससे ज्यादा भी हो सकता है कहीं कहीं एक एक जिला में. ऐसे करके आपको 116 जिले में हर एक में 25,000 के नंबर में हम कैलकुलेट करते जाना. ये नहीं है कि सिर्फ 25,000 कुल मिलाकर के उत्तर प्रदेश के लिए दे रहे हैं, नहीं, एक जिला में कम से कम 25,000 का संख्या है हमारे पास.
तो मैम ये संख्या क्या बढ़ सकती है अगर आगे जो है हम
बढ़ सकते हैं, अगर नंबर के मुताबिक कोई और 10-15 छूट गए वो ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं, परवा नहीं, उसको भी जोड़ लेंगे. ये नहीं है कि हमारे 25,000 ही हमारे नंबर है, उससे ज्यादा कोई उस डिस्ट्रिक्ट में पहुंचे तो उनको छोड़ जाएंगे, नहीं, ये हम मिनिमम 25,000 का नंबर लेकर के कर रहे हैं, ज्यादा आने में और उनको भी जोड़ लेते हैं.
154.
I'm Paulami from India Today. My question one, obviously there's a lot of confusion about the numbers, so I just, because from the data which the secretary's group put together for the 116 districts, like a district like Siddharthnagar had over 1.6 lakh migrants who had returned, which was the highest number, if I'm not mistaken, about the data about this. So how many per district, what is the total number, if not per district, what is the total number who will get these livelihood opportunities under this program, under this Abhiyan which will be launched by the Prime Minister? Also, secondly, I wanted to understand about, this is about livelihood opportunities, what about skill set training as well, because the Skill Development Ministry is also looking at training people. They've started the Swadesh program at airports where they're taking down details of migrants who are returning from Gulf countries, etc. So what about training them and giving them jobs?
Follow me. Let me be clear here. I've explained to you that I'm talking about 25,000 at least in a district for us to start off with. And in that we've said 116 districts. Now, I have not put it out, nor was it shown here, but just for you, because you were asking specific districts. For instance, in Uttar Pradesh, Siddharthnagar is what you quoted. Yeah. Our figure is about, did you say Siddharthnagar?
Yeah.
Siddharthnagar, our figure is 1,61,796. Like that, for each of the districts, we have numbers based on what we've collected through proper survey. Now, the focus is, like rightly when the secretary presented his details, he said, we've included the KVKs. Why have we included KVKs? Because in agri-related activities, if there are people who need to be trained, who are willing to go through this training, KVKs are being brought in more for giving them the skills, particularly in agri-related matters. Now, the Swadesh portal that you're referring to, into which a lot of these expats came in, and they have immediately, even at the airport, given their details, and they've been mapped accordingly. A different set of things may apply, because now in this case, clearly the 116 districts where workers moving from one part of India to the other part, which is their native places, are the ones who are being focused. In this Clearly, we are not talking about expats who have come into the country from, let us say, the Middle East or any other part. That portal which is specifically looking at people who are coming from outside with their skill sets getting mapped through that portal, they will be attended to in a different way. But this one clearly relates to those workers, skilled, partly skilled, unskilled, largely partly skilled and largely unskilled, are the ones on which this whole presentation and the launch by the Prime Minister is going to happen on the 20th. So that's a different portal which talks about expats from overseas. I have it by district. I've not made a total of it. I'm sure we'll make it available for you.
Can we share the district-wise details also? Once you share the details, that would be great.
That's the point.
Until we come to know how many people are there in each district which have been added.
Of course, we'll try to share it. No, not a problem at all. We'll share that information.
When it comes to the money, ma'am, you said
a lot of it has been budgeted, and if need be, more money will be allocated towards the payments that need to be done in these under these 25 programs. Is this entire 50,000 crores which has been identified for this particular Rozgar Abhiyan already part of the budget, or there's some portion of it in the budget and some you will raise in the time to come?
No, it's part of the budget already. Now, what's the key thing about it? We are bringing convergence. What's another key thing about it? We are front-loading the money. What is the other key thing about it? It is directly tying up with all the migrant workers who have reached their districts. And what is the other key? The other key is all of them are going to result in asset creation.